Well, hello, welcome back to the Fish Locker. Well, hello, welcome back to the Fish Locker out on the shore. Now, the Fish Locker team are out for a walk today on the low tide line. It is a massive spring tide. So what are we going to go and do, James? We're going to go foraging. What are we hoping to find?
Crabs.
Crabs. And that, why have you got that stick?
So it can be a crab spear.
It's a crab spear.
I'd like to find a toilet.
Hannah needs a wee, but yeah, that's something completely separate. We are going to make our way. We've got another 2 hours of the ebb, so we're going to walk down as the tide's ebbing off. We're going to have a walk over an area ashore and we can see what we can find.
See lots of shells.
Yeah.
See what we can find. Right. You've got your own foraging bucket, and you have. And what have we got here? Look. What are these?
Clams.
These are cockles. And you've just found a good one there, didn't you?
Yeah.
Are you going to pick yours up and put yours in your bucket? Or is that what you've got your stick for? Go on then, pick it up.
This and this was so cool.
These are cockles.
We found our first sea creature.
Yep. And there is a tiny little auger shell. It is good to have a little look around in the high tide line, because that will give you an idea of what there is to find. Ah, and I found a dog.
They're not my budget.
Just looking around in a little bit of pools, there are some gorgeous little cockle shells. But also, every now and again, you find a full one. There's a clam. You're not in your bucket? Okay. How come you've got more in your bucket than I've got in mine? Yeah, a little baby cockle. There are some. Look, there's one there, look. Look how small it is. Yeah. There's a little tiny baby razor clam. They're so thin you can see through them, look. And every now and again you find a full one. That's about legal size. I want to be checking them when they're bigger than that. In these areas of sand there are lots and lots of these little tiny razor clam shells. There's one. There's one that hangs. They're almost like a type of fingernail, aren't they? Like a gel.
Yeah.
And there is a native oyster. These are carpet shells. That is a king cockle shell.
Oh.
Carpet shell there. And these are slipper limpets. These are an actually invasive species, these slipper limpets. They're that well established though in areas in the UK now where they're almost considered as being native. Hannah's just called me over and she was like, I think I've found something. This here is a whelk shell with three big anemones on it.
I thought someone had lost a melon.
You know what they look like, don't you? There's usually a hermit crab living in there. He's probably ditched this one for one that hasn't got three great big hitchhikers on its back. Yeah. There's a little hermit crab there, look. Oh yeah, it's a nice big auger shell. That's like your textbook one when someone says they've found a spiral shell on the beach, don't they? You got anything in it? Yeah, it's got a living creature in it. We'll leave that one where it is. What I'm looking for when I'm walking along the bank like this is the holes of these razor clams. What they are is, see all these little tiny slits here? That's got a razor clam in it. That one's too small, you can tell by the size of the hole. What we're looking for is we're looking for one of those that's about a centimetre. When I find one, I'll show you what we're going to do. James, come and see what I've just found. Try and tell me what that is there.
A spider trap.
It's a crab, look.
Oh my god, look at it!
See how it's covered itself in little sponges?
Oh, I was going to say, is it a sponge? But oh, look at him! How cool is he, James?
So tall.
He's got camouflage on his back, hasn't he?
What's that one called in Moana that has all the stuff on his back?
I'm so shiny!
Is he a decorator crab?
Tamatoa.
I found a little queenie scallop.
Oh yeah.
On a whole load
on
of mussels.
On a cluster of mussels.
There's a dog.
There is a dog. I think it's a wild foraging dog. Oh yeah, he's quitting about the place, isn't he? He's like, oh no, they've seen me. Stay still. There, look. James, what have we found here?
Cuttlefish eggs.
What are these?
Cuttlefish eggs.
Cuttlefish eggs, you're right, they are.
And a little anemone.
Yeah, and a little anemone. This actually here isn't an anemone. That, if you can see it, is a sea hare.
Sea hare?
Yeah, it's like a little sea slug. Look, see it on my finger now?
Yeah.
It's a little sea slug called a sea hare.
Do you want to put it on the wee?
No, no, what we'll do is I'll put it in the water in a second. But these, when they get upset and they get scared, they make lots of purple ink come out. You see its face, look? See his little antennas?
Yeah.
Mm. And he was next to all the cuttlefish eggs. Yes, James, you're right. Well, and another little hermit crab.
Mm, yeah.
Can you see him?
Yeah.
I tell you what, you did a good spot there.
Yeah.
What's this? Oh, slipper limpets. And what else are we going to find? Let me just take a photo of this little sea hare and then we'll get him back, okay? Good lad. Well done. Do you want to hold him?
No, thank you.
No, thank you. Okay. Right. We're just walking through and Hannah has just shouted me that she's found something. Wait there. Let's get there for you.
I noticed this little, like...
Right, just wait.
Seaweed sticking up like a flag. And... it's quite a big scallop.
Turn it over. There we are.
Does that keep his eyes?
Definitely.
Yay!
Actually, wait there, what's that?
Wait.
There's something moving on there. You don't give it a wash off, just give it a quick swirl. Oh, amazing. Well done.
Oh, look at that.
A little anemone.
Yay!
Well done.
Sorry.
Guess we can share them, James.
Oh my goodness!
Right, from up there on my shoulders, can you see any more?
Oh, is this?
No, that's a dead one.
I know, but it's still a shell.
You can pick it up. It might be alive, it might just be upside down.
Do they not generally sit that way?
No, they okay. Sit flat side up. You sit with the... sit with the fat side into a hole in the sand.
Oh no!
They don't stick out.
Yeah.
Cuttlefish are living in there.
Cuttlefishes do live in there. Yeah. That's why we end up.
You know the babies were living in these ones.
Yeah.
The babies were living in one.
Right there. And Canis, your mum's winning. She's found loads more than us.
My iron now. Mm. After all those false alarms. Ready?
Just wait, just wait. Can you see it still?
Yeah. Better be it.
Yeah, for all this build up.
Oh, fuck, it bit me. Sorry. Oh, whoopsie. It bit me.
Well
go. Done. Gah.
Got your eye in now, aren't you? Come on, James. Come on, James, you need to help me now. We need to find some. Your mum's winning.
Oh, oh, oh! What? There's a new type of seaweed.
Oh, what have we got here, look? We've got a dogfish egg. Oh, can I bend down and pick it up without getting... You going over your wellies? Well, you're wet now, you might as well keep going.
You're getting wet too.
No, I'm not wet yet. You found another? Ah. I think we've come the wrong way, James.
Can I put the camera?
Your mum's doing all the finding.
We're all doing the... You better go over to
the tea. Yeah, I better do the cooking, eh? Right, not to let the side down, we found a baby one.
What?
Well, your mum's well and truly over her wellies. We found one.
We're winning.
No, we're not. Your mum's still winning. But we have found one, look. You see there?
I see this. What? What the?
That one I dropped on the way back. Yeah. My wellies are so wet.
You're going over your wellies?
So much.
Well, that's it, honey. You're already wet. You might as well keep doing it.
Where's the only tub of this?
Well, you just have to keep your eye out, won't you? Here is another dogfish egg. Now look.
Is that a baby?
It is, it's a baby dogfish. What have we got over here? Look, I don't know if you can see it properly, but there, you see it moving? There's a little dragonette. James, turn around, look. See the little fish swimming away?
Yeah.
There he is, look, see at the end of your stick. Oh, there he goes. But this here is a sea sponge, look. See it?
Yeah.
Like SpongeBob. Yeah.
Who
lives in a pineapple under the sea?
SpongeBob SquarePants.
Yeah.
Can you tell me?
No, no, you're okay. You just need to walk slow. That way it won't go in your wellies. There have been quite a lot of small flatfish and they're just too fast for the camera. But there, I don't know if you can see. Oh, well, the silting disturbance. Scallops are having a good clap. James? No, come here. Come here and I'll put you on my shoulders. Right, James, what have we just found? What's that there, look? No, look. You see it?
Yes. Like an African free diver.
What is that?
Basically over the course of the year.
Wow!
Keep looking.
So I win.
Yeah, you're winning. You've got more in your bucket, haven't you?
Mum's losing.
Mum's losing? Well, I think Mum's still winning, actually.
What? A little double
chatter. Yeah. Keep looking, keep looking. Oh, there's another one. You see it?
Yeah.
Do you want to get that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll get that one.
Can you see it?
Yes.
See it hiding in its little hole? So roll your sleeve up and you're going to help me. You've helped me find it. Come on, let's lift it up. What we need to do... You need to put your hand up underneath the sand. Come on.
It just tickled.
It just tickled. Come on then, put your hand underneath the sand at the back. Like this, look. And then you go... You got it?
Yeah.
Right, clean all the sand off then. Give it a good wash. Wash, wash, wash. Good find. Well done.
Can I rinse my
hand? Yeah, you can. You found a real good one then. Right, well, we've found some fantastic scallops. This is, there you can see the scallop inside of there. The orange part is the roe and the white part is the meat. A bit of seaweed on top. This is the size that we're keeping. And Hannah has found two lovely little ones. Turn them over. Turn them over, look. Wow, that one is lovely and pink, isn't it, look?
Yes, and that pink,
yeah.
It's pink.
These ones are too small. This is the size. So you see the difference, can't you? So we'll take the, that's a lovely looking one, that pink one. We're going to take those two out into the deeper water there and we'll let them go.
Just put them in my wellies.
Yeah. You've got 2 pints of water in each wellie, haven't you?
Can I put them in this water?
I'll take them out.
Let's take a photo of them and we'll take them further out, okay?
Ta-da.
They're so pretty, aren't they?
Yeah.
Right, James, what have we found here? Look, not only is there a lovely orange anemone there, I think that's a daisy anemone. And we have
a dogfish egg.
That there is going to grow into a dogfish shark, isn't it? And there is another spot by Hannah.
That it's got one underneath it.
It's a male protecting a female, look. Look, see him?
Are they, what type of crabs are they, velvet?
Yeah.
He's just a fancy one.
Yep, he's very camouflaged, isn't he? Protecting a little one underneath. That little one underneath is going to be peeling. So we'll leave them on their way. Here is a couple of anemones. These are your daisy anemones, and that is a gem anemone. Look at them. Whoa. Whoa. I'll tell you what, it's long.
Let's throw this water out.
Very long. How deep is that one? Yeah, goes right down to that rock. That's about 3 inches long, that. A nice painted top shell. And some bright orange sponges. Those there, I know the name of those. It's called something like a chimney sponge. I will research that and I'll give you the proper name. Here we have a couple of different types of snake locks anemone, a queen scallop shell, and these purple corals are called merle. James, what have you got in your bucket? It is a top knot.
Top
knot? Yeah, look.
How big do they get?
Probably about as big as my two hands together, but yeah, I think record, British record size is about 12 ounce. What they do is they kind of suction on, look, to like the undersides of rocks. Yeah.
Oh, right. Fell.
Sit yourself down, squat down a little bit. Is that right? Right, hold your hands out. Hold your hands together. There, look.
Oh.
Right, all you need to do is just lower him down into the water and he'll swim off your hands. Watch.
Oh, bye bye fella.
Well, if you just set yourself down on something. He's just sucked himself onto a rock here. There, look. You wouldn't even be able to see him now, would you?
Hello.
Right, we've had all of the ebb. The tide has started to flood back in again now, so we're going to have to move from it. But we have had a fantastic time. How many have we found, James?
So many.
Look, just come here and just have a quick look in. These are some fantastic scallops in here. I'm just going to see if you can... If you find any of these on the shore, and they are a little bit open like that.
Oh.
See how it claps? If they are a little bit open, all you need to do is give them a little bit of a tap. And if they close up shut tight like this, look, and you can't get them open, that means they're alive. If they're alive, then they're good to take. If they don't close up, it means they're dead. Now it is. We found probably 20. I think you found more than anybody, didn't you?
Yep, I did.
Yeah, found about 20 keepers. So we've kept 9. James has been collecting some fantastic shells.
Ta-da!
I really like that.
Found some gorgeous scallop shells. I think that James is going to take these into school. Now, we were coming down here with the intention of finding shellfish. If we'd have found any cockles or any razor clams, that type of thing, we would have gone for that.
But now.
You want to talk about your shells? Go on then.
Okay, this is... Tell me what this is.
That's a cockle.
A turtle?
It's only a little one though, isn't it?
If we hadn't have found any scallops, we would have kept the cockles and the razor clams and the mussels. But because we've found some scallops, we're going to leave all the rest of these. We're going to let them all go.
What's that one, James?
A turtle.
King cockle.
That's a king cockle, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we're going to keep a couple of these shells for James to take to school. We're going to keep 9 of the scallops and we're going to let everything else go. Now we're going to go now and we're going to, like I said, we're going to get out of there because the tide's coming in. We're going to go to somewhere else to cook these up. We are going to stop off at the shop. That is a mussel. Well done.
We are going to stop off at the shop and pick up a couple of ingredients to cook these with, and we will see you over there.
We're down on the beach where we're going to have our cook up. We stopped off at the shop on the way. We've got some pasta, we've got some little cubes of pancetta and some double cream. So we're going to fry the scallops, then the pancetta, cook the pasta, and then we're just going to mix it all together like a nice creamy seafood spaghetti. But they didn't have spaghetti. Scallops are still in the bucket, so John's going to shuck these and then we can get cooking.
Keep clapping at us.
Like a speed record today, aren't you?
Right tool for the job.
You or the knife? I learnt this in Spargo's kitchen. So I've melted the butter. Now what I'm going to do is put the scallop in the melted butter and then into the pan, so that you don't get loads of like splashing and sizzling around. And it means each of the scallops is nicely coated. I only want the white in the action.
So you can separate them off.
I'm gonna fry the coral in with the bacon. So I've got a nice golden colour on them now. And when you do it in a clock, you know which ones you've turned.
They don't take long at all, do they?
No. And you don't want to overcook them because they'll just turn into like little balls of rubber, like a gobstopper. Just got some pancetta that we're going to flash fry. Scallops and bacon is such a good combo. I am going to add some pepper. I'm not going to bother with salt because obviously it's seafood, the bacon's salty, so you don't want to overdo it. Give it a little bit of pepper.
I love that one. That just smells delicious. That
smells like breakfast. Do you want garlic in there?
You wanna, when you're sticking the corns in, right at the end.
Do you want garlic in there?
Yeah, I don't know. You stick a little bit in. Not so much. Some crazy garlic on the go.
Crazy garlic. That I've chopped with this.
It's like a Blue Peter one, that one.
Yeah.
Does smell amazing.
Get these two shells out at work.
Alright, that looks good. So we're gonna have to wait a few minutes now because we're gonna boil some water to cook our pasta in. We did buy fresh pasta just because it's quicker to cook, not because we're that fancy.
If we were doing this and we had two stoves, you could be doing the pasta at the same time.
And ideally we probably would have done the pasta first, but we didn't want to run out of gas and not have cooked the scallops, because obviously that's what we're here for. Sorry, I was
going to flag.
Wildlife. We just bought some fresh water with us to cook the pasta in. Probably could have just done it in seawater, but never mind. We might need James's bottle as well.
You've been drinking that, haven't you?
Luckily, we had James's.
Ready James's bottle.
Jellyfish backup. We have got other water. We're not dehydrating it. Please don't.
He's there, look, drinking.
It's not
a can of Stella. Is that good?
Yeah.
Now James is having a can of Stella and we're drinking water.
Is that still warm?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Right, we've drained the pasta off. James is having plain pasta.
Good lad.
There we go.
You want to enjoy yourself?
No, I'm just going to add... I'm going to keep the coral separate because I'm going to put them on top as a fancy garnish. I'm just going to put those back in. I'm going to put in some double cream. And some lemon. Give it a quick stir around.
Sure.
Now, if I was at home and we had a bit of parsley or something, obviously some green would make it look pretty. I've got to turn the stove off now.
You're finished?
Three for starters. There you go.
Right, do you want to get...
Not too shabby for the beach.
There you go.
Sunday, Sunday dinner is served.
Oh yeah. Looks fantastic. And with that as a setting, there's your pasta.
Do you want some more lemon?
You can. I'd like some butter to add with the bread, please, if that's possible.
Huh?
You want a bit of bread?
Yes!
Pasta!
Do you want a knife?
Fucking sand flies in it. Do you want some butter on your bread, James? Thank you.
I think
I am conscious that the battery's dying in the GoPro, so we're going to finish eating all of this and then we're going to make our way back. I hope you've enjoyed joining us on the shore today. We've had a fantastic little walk along the low tide line and we've got some amazing scallops. I like that, is absolutely delicious.
Hannah, I had to forage them and cook them today.
Hannah has really pulled it out of the bag today. Not only did she find more than both me and James did combined, but she cooked them as well.
Did we not see the tidal wave?
We did keep three of them back and we're going to drop them off at Jim's house. He does love scallops, so we thought we'd give him a couple as well. You enjoying your pasta there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
when we got here, we were like nine between two of us.
Yeah, when we got here, there were nine big ones as well. I kind of thought, yeah, we'll just keep what we've got. Please let us know if you enjoy this type of video. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, click subscribe and select the notification bell for all notifications. That way you won't miss another video that we bring out, will they?
Tiddles!
James, how many thumbs up emojis should they give us?
Ten
thumbs up
emojis, please.
Right. All the best. We'll speak to you later and
bye,
see you later.
From the
Don't talk with your mouth full. What'd you say?
Bye from the fish water. Beep.
Bye from the fishmonger.
See you later. fantastic.